Welcome to another exciting episode of Two Guys Named Mike talking about a classic Columbia comedy. And today's entry is the 1938 version of Philip Barry's Holiday, directed by George Cukor.
Well, I first saw Holiday on a double bill in my college years with Philadelphia Story, which is probably how it was usually programmed. The crowd just went wild for Philadelphia Story, which came on at, you know, the prime time, 7 or 7:30. And it is this, you know, supreme example of machine-calibrated entertainment. You know, you see every plot and subplot roll into place like the tumblers in a lock, and everybody's on their toes, and it's a great entertainment. But Holiday, which came on afterwards and is a much different, much more, I think, emotionally modulated piece, didn't have the same impact on the crowd, but I found myself leaving and really thinking about it and actually having it linger with me and stay with me much longer. And it's only grown in my estimation since then.
Well, Philadelphia Story is certainly the flashier movie. It has a bigger star cast, Jimmy Stewart, who won an Oscar. And it's a movie that was a bigger hit when it first came out because Columbia didn't own any theaters. And MGM was always a lot more conscious about keeping those pictures out there in the public, knowing they had classics. And they said, knowing that they would generate more income. So people were much more familiar with the Philadelphia Story than they were about Holiday. And generally, when you have a double feature, the second feature is never going to generate the same level of enthusiasm because at that point, audiences have seen one movie and maybe the energy level's dipping a little bit. And also, Holiday isn't as funny as Philadelphia Story. It's a comedy where everybody's droll and witty, you know, what they used to call a comedy of manners. People sipping martinis in evening clothes, you know, in a drawing room.
She should have realized that Father couldn't announce my engagement without some sort of fuss.
Should have, yes, but unlike me, Linda always hopes.
We've read the play, Holiday, and there's nothing really particularly funny in it except the traditional comedy relief characters. It's here where you've got Cukor and Grant and Hepburn and the writers working to make it a livelier and brighter picture.
Yeah. Well, I actually think it is. I mean, my two favorite definitions of comedy both come from playwrights. And one was Tennessee Williams, you know, after The Rose Tattoo premiered and to great laughter. He said, well, if they laugh, it's a comedy. But the other one is from Edward Albee. I remember at the time, a Tiny Alice, he gave an interview and he said, if the characters end up with what they want, it's a comedy. And that is really pertinent to Holiday. I think there are laughs in Holiday. I think actually the first act is a lot of fun, not just because of the repartee, but because of the unexpected things that happen.
Oh, excuse me, does Miss Julia Seaton live here?